Now here we are discussing about the floating point literals. Now there is a basic difference between the floating point literals and the integer literals. In case of integer literals, whenever we suffix the integer number with 0, that means the number is an octal number. But if we suffix the number by 0x, that means the number is a hexadecimal number. So the same thing is not valid for float. So you can say for floating point data types, we can specify literals only in the decimal form. We cannot specify in octal or hexadecimal form. For example, this is just a simple example here. So I am writing float A is equal to 123.230f. So that means it is just saying that this number is actually a floating point number. Because of this f, it is a floating point number. Okay. But if so, this is a correct notation. But if I write something like this, float A is equal to 123.230 like this. Now this is not a valid notation because here we are not using f. Therefore, we can say that this number is not representing a valid floating point number because this is a double number. By default, it is a double number. Okay. So it's a double number. Now if I write float B is equal to 0123.230f. Now because we have started this number with a suffix or prefix 0, it means that this number should be an octal number, but this is not valid in case of Java. So in Java, when you write a floating point number with the suffix 0, it will take it as a decimal number only. So this number, if you print this number or if you use this number, so it is 123.230. So this is actually a decimal number. It will not consider this number as an octal number. Okay. Now if I write float C is equal to 0x123. So in 0x123, because I'm suffixing the number with 0x, it will not consider it as a valid expression. It will say this expression is a malformed expression, or you can say this expression is not properly formulated. So you can say by default a floating point numbers literals are double type. For example, here as you can see, I have not written f here, that is why by default this number is a double type. And we can specify explicitly as a floating point type by suffixing the number by f or small f or capital F. For example, here I am suffixing this number by small f. Now let us take these examples here. So in the first case, I am writing float A is equal to 123.45. This is not valid because it will say that possible loss of precision. This number is a double number, but you are giving it in a floating point variable. So this is not a valid expression, so it will give a compile time error. But if you see float A is equal to 123.45f, because of this f, this is perfectly fine. If you see double C is equal to 123.45, this is again perfectly fine because this is a double number and you are storing a double number in a double number. If you are writing double D is equal to 123.45f, this is also valid because this is a floating point number and the size of double is bigger than the floating point number. So you can store a floating point number in a double variable, which is perfectly fine. You can also specify with capital D or small d that it is specifically it is a double number. So if I am writing 123.45d, it means it is a double number. Now if I write something like this, integer A is equal to 123 small d, or integer B is equal to 123 capital D. So because these numbers are ended with D, that means these numbers are now a double number. And you cannot store a double number in a floating point variable. So this is not correct, this is wrong. Now, we can also represent the numbers by scientific notations. For example, I can write 10E23. So this is just a scientific notation, how you can represent the number. So you can convert this number into a decimal number also. So this by default, if you write with E like this, so this is by default a double number. So it is perfectly fine. But if you write integer I is equal to 123.10E23, this is not correct because this number is a double number and this number is an integer number. Now take these examples here. If I am writing float F is equal to 0x134.456F, this is not correct. Why? Because we cannot use 0x, so it will say that it is a malformed expression, or you can say this expression is not correct. So what I am saying, it is a malformed expression. That means this expression is not properly formulated and it is not correct. If I say float I is equal to 0x34, now this is correct. So when I am writing this 12e3 with starting with 0x, now this number is actually, you have to convert this number in a hexadecimal to decimal format. So this is also correct. Remember, this is also correct. But if I am writing float k is equal to 0x123e.414. This is not correct. This is not at all correct, because again you can see this number as I specified earlier also. But if you take this float L is equal to 123.e4, now this is not correct. Why this is not correct? Because of this dot and this e, because of this dot, this number is now a double number, and you are storing a double number in a floating point variable. So it is not correct. So if I am writing 123.e for f, now because of this f, this is a correct expression, because this expression is now representing a floating point number. Now if I am writing double n is equal to 123.e4, now this is also correct. See, here it was a double number, and you are trying to store this double number into a floating point variable. And here in this case, it is a by default a double number, and you are storing a double number into a double variable. So this is also correct. Now the last case, we are writing double p is equal to 123.e4f. This is also correct, because you are storing a floating point number in a double variable. So you can see what are the cases where it is valid. So if you write just 123.45, again this is not wrong, this is wrong. 123.45f, this is correct. 123.45 is in double is fine. But in the case of scientific notation, there are some cases where it is correct, some cases where it is wrong. And again, we cannot start a number by 0x. But even if you try to start a number like float I is equal to 0123.45f, now this is a correct expression, but the thing is, it is going to take this number as a decimal number, it is not going to take this number as a octal number. So in case of floating point numbers, even if you start with 0, it will not take the number as a octal number, it will always take the number as a decimal number. And 0x, if you start the number by 0x, that means 0x means it is not a well-formed expression. Now in the next video, let us discuss about the correct literals.